Hello and welcome to Ton TV, the Green at Morton weekly update, as sponsored by McTears, the auctioneers. It's great to be back. My special guest this week arrived on trial during the summer, but he's been picking up plaudits and Man of the Match awards as he's come along in this season. He's a very, very impressive figure altogether, which is impressive for me because he plays in the hardest part of the pitch, between the sticks.
Ian, I'm always interested in how goalkeepers become goalkeepers. It seems to be a position you have to want to play. How did you get into it?
My dad was a goalkeeper, actually. He was, for a young age, I think. He played in goals and he came through youth at Dundee United. Never managed to, break into the first team. But I think he always wanted me to be a goalkeeper, and it's turned out that way.
Various people have said to me, he's not tall enough to be a goalkeeper, but you're 6'2", you know?
I'm 6'2". Maybe not, your typical 6'7", but I feel like I've got a presence. I feel that, I've had feedback for my back four saying that as well, so,
Heroes when you were growing up, are there goalkeepers that you looked up to and wanted to be?
Oh, well, my favourite would be Edwin van der Sar, Manchester United. Just the all-round goalkeeper. He was kind of ahead of his time. He was both-footed. Could strike the ball really well with both feet, coming for crosses, just a big dominant goalkeeper and just really, really good. Just made match winning saves all the time for Manchester United, and it just showed with, under Sir Alex Ferguson, winning titles and that. So just always looked up to him since a young age.
To be fair, in your career, you've worked with a couple of top internationalists like Alan McGregor, Craig Gordon. What did you learn from these guys?
Just about giving your all every day and just the professionalism they show on and off the pitch, if it's before training, getting their body ready for, going out to train and delivering their best and just having the highest standards, because both of them are, Scotland international goalies, and, it's just working with them every day. It was good for me as a young boy, just setting those standards that I've still got with me today. So,
did you catch up with Craig when Hearts came through?
Yeah, obviously it was a disappointing result against Hearts, but I spoke to him after the game, gave me some good feedback, so it's always nice to hear for a seasoned pro like him, so it was good.
You can't talk about the Hearts game without talking about that save. What do you remember about it?
It was just a reaction save, really. It was just kind of, I had the one before it, grew in confidence for Whiting, I think it was a volley into my right, and the one inside the box I touched on the bar, it was just pure reactions. I sort of really got to see on it. Just pure reaction, stepped on the bar and managed to keep it out. So,
but your form has been very, very impressive. I mean, even the save last week against Inverness, how did you get to that one?
It was a bit unorthodox, but I was kind of just aiming to keep it out of the net, really. In the first half, I think probably after that, I thought I should have just moved my feet and caught it, but at the end of the day, managed to get a clean sheet. And that's something that me, not just me, but the full team coming through the front to the back, and as a back four, just keeping clean sheets. So it's something that we've kind of prided ourselves on this season, is keeping clean sheets. And, if you keep a clean sheet, then you're always going to get a chance in the game to, pick up the 3 points. So I think, like I say, it's just about keeping as many clean sheets as possible and letting the strikers and the creative players, try and win the game for us.
And being in the first team, it's been a big, big season for you, hasn't it, to do that?
Yeah, it was definitely something that I had to do this season. From the start of the season, I came in trial, and it was something that I needed to do this season, was play regular football week in, week out. And thankfully so far, from the last manager and Timo, they put a lot of faith in me, and I'll always be grateful for that. It's given me the chance to play a good level at the Championship, play week in, week out. So I'm loving it, just about keeping that going to the end of the season.
Of course, your big pal Conor Hazard, he's broken through as well. This has been quite a season for the two of you.
Yeah, used to travel in with Hazzy in the mornings. He used to take me in to training up at Lennox Town. So he was always a hard worker, so no surprise to see him in the first team.
Let's look ahead. Queen of the South at the weekend, artificial surface. You'll be looking forward to the game, obviously, but...
Yeah, it was just another game. They're coming quite thick and fast now after, obviously, I had a few called off, which players like games week in, week out. So it's good. But we've obviously got Inverness coming up during the weekend and Arbroath as well, but looking ahead to the Queen's game, we're going to go there and try and get the 3 points. I think it'll be a tough game. We know what Queen of the South are, but we'll be looking to go and get 3 points. You know,
a goalkeeper's nightmare, that surface, or are you just?
No, I think obviously I've been almost brought up playing on Astro most of the time, so I'm used to that now. So I don't think it'll really affect me as a goalkeeper or any of the boys, because a few teams in the Championship play on it, but we're looking forward to the game. Hopefully we can get the 3 points.
And then, as you say, Inverness Cali at home on Wednesday night, 6:30 kick off now, of course.
Yeah, it was the first time obviously we've played Inverness this season, so you know, we'll do our analysis on them, but not really sure as of yet. Obviously thinking ahead to the Queen's game first, but you know, a lead up start of next week will give us a better insight to what Inverness obviously hold, but again, Queen's game comes first.
Realistic ambition this year is to get to the playoffs.
Yeah, of course that would be nice. You know, playoffs would be ideal, but just need to take one game at a time. Just now, you know, it's a good run that's coming up. You know, kind of teams that we feel that we should be, you know, maybe picking up 3 points against. We just need to hopefully, you know, pick up 3 points where we can, and see what it takes us for the rest of the season.
You've already had more clean sheets this year than Morton had last year. What do you put that down to?
Obviously, I think it's a personal pride I take in getting clean sheets. It helps. It's not just me. It's the defence as well. You know, it's when I'm called upon. Hopefully, I'm there to help them out. But defence have been fantastic this season. You know, I think it's a good unit that we're working with, and it's not just me, it's obviously them as well. So I think I wouldn't put it down to anything as such, but you know, just standards within the group, I think they're matched it all over. So yeah,
exciting times at Morton. Aidan, we're hoping to see more clean sheets from you and more spectacular saves. Thanks for joining us today.
Cheers, Jay.
And thank you for joining us on the Greenock Morton weekly update, as sponsored by McTears, the auctioneers.